โอเคนะครับwelcome you to the first chapter นะครับ the first chapter gonna discuss with you about the basic concept of the cost management you may wonder why cost is important นะครับ I would like to give you some idea in brief before we move on when you look at the cost management or when you look at the cost that is basically the money that you pay out for someone.I would like to metaphor like this. For example, you conduct your business and you get 500,000 in terms of the revenue. However, you need to pay for the employee, you need to pay for your supplier, you need to pay several expenses. Some of the costs, they have a direct impact on your product. For example, we open bakery shop. You need to bake the bread,You need to prepare the cake and you need to make your product. Now, later on, we call that is the direct cost. However, you also have other costs. For example, you rent a shop, okay? You pay for the facility expense for the shopping mall, you see? So that thing later on, we call indirect cost. Now, some of the costs that they have a direct impact on your product,We call direct cost, and some of the other related cost to your business is called indirect. Now, that is some example. So, if you receive 500,000 and you pay out for 350,000, it means that you may have profit around 150,000. You see, so cost is concerned about the cash outflow, the money you pay to someone. So, my goal is that.If you understand this technical term clearly, you can manage your cost concern in the future, whether you work in the professional company or whether you work in your own business. So this course is quite important for the both perspectives. Whether you work as an entrepreneur or whether you work in your family-owned business, cost is much more important.Because every money is your money, okay? So at first, I would like to raise your awareness about the word cost, okay? So welcome everyone to the first chapter, cost management and strategy, okay? If you have any question, feel free to drop me a message. Feel free to open your mind and let me know, okay? So here is the learning objectives that we are going to discuss in this chapter.Okay, basically this chapter is a foundation. So now I would like to give you information. I would like to discuss with you about some example. So the first important keyword that we are going to understand this morning together is about the cost management information. Everything here, we begin with the word information. Okay, so when you look at those data, we need to,understand them from the information perspective, and it's going to help you in terms of the decision making. For example, you manage the logistic company, and then later on, the oil price is getting up, you see? That affects your cost of your business directly, you see? So we need to understand why this information is very important. After that, we are going to discuss about the four functions of management.And basically, these four functions, they need a good information. They want to manage something if they have a very clear information so they can come up with the right decision. Okay, so after you understand about the cost management information, the keyword is information. After that, you are going to discuss about the word four function.Whether you operate your own business, whether you operate a professional company, four function is always there. After that, we are going to discuss about the type of the organization. For example, manufacturing, for example, retailer, for example, wholesaler, service company. You see, there are several types of the business and all of them,they have different perspective when they are looking at cost. If we manage the manufacturing factory, basically we concern about the cost of raw material, the cost of the conversion. But if you work on the retailer, basically you buy some finished product and you resell it, you see. So they have a different in term of the perspective on the cost. Okay, nah? So these are the important concept that we are going to discuss together in the first chapter. We are going to discuss in brief about contemporary business environment. There are some new trends, there are some new movement in the industry right now. And as I have let you know, this is the latest version of the textbook. Nah? So it is the most up-to-date version. Nah? And then finally, we are going to discuss about the type of the competitive strategies. Nah? So what are the competitive strategy? Nah? It means your strategy towards success. Nah? We have two keywords, Kap. Differentiation and cost leadership. Okay, we have two keywords here. We have cost leadership. So each company, they aim for success. However, they have different strategy. The first one is the differentiation. Now, I would like to note down in your paper. It is also important for your future. It is also important for your exam. Differentiation. You try to come up with some product that differentiate yourself from other competitor. For example, you offer the most premium first class and you charge the customer 300,000. You see, differentiation. Customer is very, they are willing to pay more and more to receive a high standard of service. On the other side, some of the company, they focus on the cost leadership. They have a very concern on the cost. If you look at your drinking water, okay, this is some example of my drinking water. Now, basically, they sell around 13 or 14 baht per 1.5 liter. Now, you see, 14 or 15 baht. And then there are a lot of the water brand that they sell around this price. You see, they compete on cost, okay? But the first example, when you look at some premium product, brand name, luxury good, they are focused on the differentiation, okay? So differentiation and cost leadership, they have different philosophy of doing the business. In terms of the cost leadership, they try to provide as cheap as they can, okay? But in terms of the differentiation, they provide the most satisfaction, they provide the most satisfactory for the customers. So in terms of the cost leadership is very serious on the cost management, okay? Because anyway, they need to sell the water around this price. But if you look at the brand name or luxury bag, you see 150,000 Thai baht, you see? So they have less concern on the cost matter. So at first, I would like you to see the overview of this chapter. I believe that after the end of this chapter, you have a clear understanding on why cost is important, okay? Some of you, you are going to work in the professional company, you are going to be a management of the company. Cost is important. Some of you are going to operate your family-owned business. Cost is much more important. Every baht is your family money, okay? So let's have a look and enjoy the lesson together. If you have any question, if you need any support, feel free to let me know. So the first concept that we are going to discuss together is what we call information. Okay. So later on, all of the things that we are going to discuss throughout the course, try to provide related information regarding to the cost. If you come up with the primary data, there are a lot of information. We need to group them. We need to classify them. So the management of the company understand the situation of the cost better. Okay. So cost management information consists of financial and non-financial information. นะครับ It's come in a number. It's come in an explanation. It's come in a several form. However, what is the goal? Used to implement the strategy. For example, ครับ This is one bottle of the water. นะครับ This is one bottle of the water. นะครับ And then our company plan to sell it at 15 บาทนะครับ But we have to control นะครับ the cost of the product no more than 3.1 บาท for example you see so anyway you need to maintain the cost of production now no more than 3 บาท for example you see so if we can manage better than that you can arrive at the better performance but you can if you cannot control that so it will affect the strategy of the company okay นะครับSo the important thing that I would like to raise your awareness is the first key term, cost management information. Now it can come in term of the financial or numbers, and it can come in form of the non-financial form information. Non-financial is mean explanation. Okay. So in the midterm exam, not just calculation, I need you provide some brief explanation as well. Okay.But don't worry นะครับ I will go step by step นะครับ I don't want to make it too much นะครับ I don't want to make it too complex for you นะครับ So what we are going to move on together in this subject is what we call cost management นะครับ development and use of the cost management information Now you come up with information and you analyze it you come up with some solution about thatนะครับ so here is the first two keywords that we are going to move on together okay นะครับ so cost management come from two keywords cost and management so that is how you manage your cost นะครับ some cost is more than you plan so you may need to revise it you may need to closely monitor it นะครับ it is not justunderstand, calculate, and arrive at the conclusion, but you need some managerial implication. Okay? So basically the role is the management accounting. Management accounting. So sometimes we can refer to the managerial accounting. Managerial accounting, what does it mean? The thing that we are going to discuss throughout this course is part of the management accounting or manager accounting. You use accounting information to support management decision. Okay, that is like an internal process. It is in the opposite way of financial, financial accounting. I put in the chat. Financial accounting is the concern ofcoming up with the financial statement นะครับ income statement balance sheet cash flow statement of those things you see if you remember about the accounting class but we are not preparing that we are going to participate in part of the management decision if you have alternative for example นะ if you have which alternative which one is better for youThis is the management accounting, okay? Ajahn, we come up with two choice. The first one is to set up the business in Nonthaburi, and the second option is to set up the business in Singhburi, for example. Nonthaburi is better in terms of the cost of raw material. However, in Singhburi, it is better in terms of the transportation, for example. You see, you need to make a decision whether you will set up your new factory in which alternatives, you see. So information that you are going to understand from this course will help you to make a decision. It will help you to plan for your business, and it helps you to control, นะครับand implement your strategy okay it is like you come up in the first term You aim for grade 3, you see. After the first term, you may arrive at 3.2, 3.3, 3.1, you see. You need to understand about your effort and the outcome, you see. So that is like a business. Now, you have a sales revenue, you have the cost. Okay, now, that are a very similar thing. So here is the definition from what we call Institute of Management Accountant. Now, that is like an international association for the accounting people. But right now, I would like you to understand that cost management is part of the managerial accounting. Managerial accounting is mean accounting to help the management make a decision. Okay, it is not just a financial report, put the report there. No, it helps you to make a decision. Okay, so why this thing is very important. If you study the course called operation management before, they said that every organization, they have at least three important functions. We call the important tripod for the company. You need to have a finance function. You have to have a marketing function, and you need operation function. These are the three primary functions in the organization. Each of them, you must have it. When you look at the operation, it's concerned about the product and service for the customers. When you look at the marketing, it deals with how you attract your customers. And finally, you need to talk about money. So we need finance in the company, okay? So what we are looking here, we are part of this field, Chief Financial Officer. And then you can see that every company, they may have CEO, sometimes they call Managing Director, Managing Director or MD, MD, Managing Director. So every company, you need at least three functions. We cannot say that, oh, our company, we don't have marketing. Our company, we don't have finance. No. At least three functions. You study logistic management, that is part of the operation. These are the most important three functions. We cannot miss anyone here. Okay. So in terms of the chief financial officer or CFO, this is the higher up position in terms of the finance and accounting. So you will have controller, treasurer, and information officer. Some of you said, Ajahn, what is controller? What is the treasurer? Controller is the accounting manager, and treasurer is the finance manager. Maybe you note down in your paper. In the modern organization, they would not say accounting manager, they say controller. Okay, this might be some new keyword for you. Have a look here. Accounting manager, it is equal to what we call controller. And finance manager, it is equal to treasurer. So if you meet these people in the organization, they said, hey, hello, Bob. I am controller of this company. It's mean, hello, Bob. I am accounting manager of the company. Okay. Hello, people. I am treasurer of this company. He said, I am finance manager of the company. Okay. So in this course, we are focusing on the cost management. And basically, cost management is part of the accounting department. Okay, now they still call accounting department, but the position called controller. Okay, now, but in the past, in the past 20 or 30 years, they call accounting managers, but right now they call controller. Okay, so controller, basically they oversee cost management, financial reporting. นะครับ so financial reporting is concerned about balance sheet, income statement, and statement of cash flow, some kind of those financial statement. นะครับ however ครับ cost management is part of the managerial accounting. นะครับ it help not just reporting, but what are the insight of that information and how we are going to adjust our strategy. For example ครับ oh boss we operate logistic company right now we have around 30% of the normal car and we have 50% of the EV นะครับ we can see that the oil price is getting up along the way so we should shift to the EV and then we have some estimate of the cost of the energy that EV gonna pay back within 6 years and we believe thatthis option is better for the company. You see, they need a very good cost management to understand about existing situation as well as planning for the future. Okay, so นะครับ this chapter this subject นะครับ that is part of accounting นะครับ so we will focus on the course only นะครับ so right now before we move on to thefollowing topics I would like you to understand where are we in the organization นะครับ where are we why we need this course okay basically I deliver finance course นะครับ but normally finance and accounting they are like a brother and sister together นะครับ so right now I hope you have a clear understanding like this นะครับ when you close your eye you see the logistic companyThey are all about cost management. นะครับ if you know the company called Flash Logistics, นะครับ if you know about those logistics company or airline business, นะครับ they're all concerned about cost. นะครับ that's why it is important for us to move on together and gain some concept. นะครับ so I hope that right now you understand about the typical organization chart. นะครับ some of you might have a question. อาจารย์ where is HR? Where is technology? Where is procurement? You see, so those are supporting function. นะครับ but every organization we need these three important department. Okay.The first chapter, I will move a little bit slow. นะครับ I would like you all to have a very clear management perspective on why this subject is important. So, every company, นะครับ cost management information will be part of the decision making somehow. Information that we are going to discuss in this course, นะครับany component will support in the following four management function นะครับ so any management in the company basically they do these four function the first one is strategic management okay where our company we are going to what is our goal in our business what is our strategy that we are going to achieve that goal you seeSo that is called strategic management. Oh, we are going to provide the premium air service. We are going to provide the most premium and luxury airlines. So they pursue the differentiation. But another way, Cap, everyone can fly.We fly at you can fly at the low cost you see so they focus on the cost leadership you see actually airline they have a different strategy so that is the first function of management we call strategic management okay planning and decision making นะครับ this is like an operation นะครับ they focus on the planning for the next periodนะครับ for example we plan for 2,000 million baht revenue next quarter you see so they try to plan for some future นะครับ and then they make some decision นะครับ with the relevant cost as I told you we are going to put our distribution center in Nonthaburi, or we are going to put our new distribution center in Singhburi, or we are going to put them in Bangkok, Kanchana Pisek, for example. So three of the location here, นะครับ, this is Bangkok. So you see, they need to compare pro and con. นะครับ. After that, we talk about the management and operation control. What does it mean? It means every daily operation, we need to record the cost. Okay, นะครับ. So,Hi boss, my name is Vasu. I am a management accountant. I would like to report your performance of the last month. Now, our cost is better than planned. We report 3% lower than our planned cost, you see. So that is like a management of the daily operation as well as to control the operation. Boss, last month, oil price is getting larger than what we planned for 15%. That's why it affects our cost for 12%. You see, that is the operational control. I would like to encourage you one thing. In the company or in your own business, you need to closely monitor the number in the company. Income and revenue and the cost. It is like you receive 5,000.As the monthly expense, and you use 4,000, you see. So income is more than outcome, outflow. You see, but if you receive 5,000, but you spend 10,000, you see. So you report, นะครับ, more cash outflow than inflow. Finally, ครับ, this cost information, นะครับ, will be part of the preparation of the financial statement, นะครับ, I hope that you all know about the income statement balance sheet already. You see, so these are the four functions of the management of the company, and basically they need a good number to support their decision. That is the goal. So the first thing is the strategic management. We are going to move faster and help one by one. Now we talk about the strategic management. So it is about identifying and implementing goal, นะครับ, and action plan to maintain competitive advantage, นะครับ. So it is about how you identify your goal, นะครับ. What is your plan for the GPA, GPA this term? You see, some of you may think that, oh,we are going to put our huge effort in this term, and we plan for 3.2, for example. You see, so you have your goal, and you need some smart plan to achieve that goal. Okay, that is a strategic management. The second thing is the planning and decision making. Information is need to support recurring decision. What does recurring mean? It means ongoing.นะครับ every day in your business in your life you need to make a decision. For example, schedule your production plan. You may need to know about the existing inventory in your warehouse. You may need to know about other things so you can plan production. นะครับ oh, we are going to produce the bottle of water 3,000 bottle today. We are going to produce 5,000 today according to the request from the customers. Management and operational control. So cost is about operation efficiency. That's why later on you will see we are going to discuss about what we call direct material cost. It deal directly with the material that you use to produce your product. So.นะครับ I remember when I work in the car manufacturer นะครับ we have to monitor the cost we have monitor ongoing cost very closely นะครับ and finally นะครับ the management function นะครับ the last one is to prepare the financial statement นะครับ whether you are the limited company whether you are the public company นะครับYou need to report your financial statement. Okay, so the last thing is that you need to prepare the financial statement, and basically, the part of them they're concerned about the cost. So these are the management function in the company. So cost management, they have a very direct นะครับ relationship to this strategic management นะครับ if you implement some strategy and you say that it not work นะครับ you may need to adjust your strategy you may need to come up with some new tactic and technique นะครับ and then we talk about planning we talk about the control the daily operation and finally we talk about the financial reporting นะครับอ่ะ so นะครับlet me see the slide first นะครับ oh we are around page 9 okay during the class if you have any question drop me a message นะครับ maybe around 10 something we can have a short break before we coming back นะครับ so นะครับ right now I would like to discuss with you about the several types of organization นะครับone thing I would like to let you know is that นะครับ in our subject we also have term project นะครับ so when you present your term project นะครับ at that time I require you to open the camera so you talk with your friend see you นะครับ but right now นะครับ no need for that นะครับI respect your privacy concern นะครับ however นะครับ if you have any question feel free to let me know นะครับ during the class we may have some activity together นะครับ later on I let you know นะครับ have a look here have a look here นะครับ we have several type of the organization นะครับ and all of them they have a different in term of the cost nature นะครับI will discuss 1, 2, 3, 4 with you. After that, we may have some question and answer. So, in each organization or in every industry, they have a different nature. They have a different nature. This different nature will reflect on the different cost pattern. It will affect on the different cost management.The first type of organization is what we call manufacturer. They produce some product. For example, Apple company produce phone. Water company sell the water company sell the bottle of water. Okay. Yeti sell tumbler. Yeti sell tumbler. นะครับ Yeti sell tumbler. นะครับ Alcohol spray company sell this product. You see. So.Manufacturer basically they produce some product and then they sell the product so the cost they are very important and they're concerned with the raw material cost okay so when you look at the manufacturer and we are going to discuss about that later on we are going to focus about the cost of producing the product that is the manufacturerOkay. So when you work in the manufacturer, now your cost is concerned about the product, how you are going to produce that product. The second type of the organization is the merchandiser. For example, 7-Eleven, they didn't produce some product on their own. They buy and sell. So merchandiser, we can call middlemen.Okay, middleman, นะครับ so middleman buy from someone, sell to someone. We have wholesaler, you all know about that already. Wholesaler buy in a large lot and also sell in a large lot, นะครับ but retailer ครับ buy in a large lot and sell into a small lot, นะครับSo maybe the wholesaler we can metaphor like a macro and retailer we can metaphor like 7-Eleven you see when you are interested to buy in a large lot you go to macro for example so macro is the wholesaler they sell toothpaste to you maybe at least 24 item in a large pack you see but when you go to 7-Eleven you can buy just one toothpaste.You see, so that is the difference between wholesaler and retailer. นะครับ Sorry นะครับ sometimes just make a small keyword in Thai นะครับ wholesaler is in Thai is mean ผู้ค้าส่ง okay and retailer in Thai is mean ผู้ค้าปลีกนะครับ just that okay so in terms of the wholesaler in terms of the retailer when they talk about the cost they are not concerned with the production they concerned with the price that they buy that product you see soThat is the same word cost, but these four types of the organization they have different perspective. When you look at manufacturing, they are concerned about the production cost. When you look at the merchandise, they concerned about the product cost. The third one is the service firm. Okay, service firm. For example, I provide.Barber service. You come, I cut your hair, I'm taking care of your hair, you see? So that is the service firm. So service firm, they're concerned about expense for the people. They have some concern about the cost of the some product that they use for the service, you see? So the first three, they have different perspective when they're looking at cost. So when you look at the airline, that is the service firm. They provide transportation service, you see? Okay, and the last thing is the government and non-profit organization. Basically, these organizations, they didn't sell any product or service, but they provide some of their job regarding to the government assignment, and then they provide some of their tasks, for the society, for the non-profit organization. If you know, for example, foundation, foundation to help the rural people, for example, they didn't sell anything, but they help the people, you see? So their cost basically rely on the objective of that foundation. Okay, So,From now on, Cap, I would like you to understand the different type of the organization. We have manufacturer, produce the product, merchandiser, buy and sell, service firm, provide service to the customer, and government. Okay, So I would like to ask you some question, and then you answer me in the line group, Just make ourselves a little bit fun what is the good example around here okay let me put it this way this is the back of the bread I give you a story we at our company we produce a bread but we didn't sell on our own we distribute this product to several of our customers and then they sell on their own for example I produced 1000 bags of the bread like this and then there are a lot of the people buy from me and resell on their own we just make the breadAnd then there are several middlemen come to buy and sell on their own. So if we focus on our bread factory, that is 1, 2, 3, or 4. Let me know in our like group cup. Just some of your participation. We produce a bread. So our cost is concerned about the raw material. Our cost is concerned about ingredient.And some of the bake process, So, our bread company, we are 1, 2, 3, 4, or 4, ครับ maybe just a few example. So, why we need to do something like this? I would like you all, when you go out and you see several products, several service, you need to classify into one among these type. You see.That is concerned about the cost. Okay, wow, very nice. Thank you name โอปอบูมไนซ์ฟูลี่ยูมินะครับไดลันนะครับออยกบนะ BATT นะครับ PM Benz and Om นะครับ very nice นะครับ very nice นะครับ so นะครับ the first example that we did together is about the bread manufacturer see so oh อาจารย์ I finished my bachelor in logistics right now I work for the President Food we are the bread manufacturer we didn't do any merchandise we didn't provide any service so all of the thing that we need to taking care is the production cost so this is the first example of the bread manufacturer okay นะครับ so นะครับ you see so when you understand about the nature of the business นะครับ and you will have a look through in that business and you need to understand about that cost okay นะครับ from now on นะครับ let's talk about some practical example that is very close to ourselves and after this นะครับ if everyone arrive at the nice answer we can have a short break okay นะครับas I let you know นะครับ 70% is gonna be a lecture นะครับ because in this subject we have quite a lot of the information but anyway I would like you to get a concept นะครับ and can apply in your real life นะครับ so why we need to talk about this for type of organization because they will have a different cost nature นะครับ we talk about manufacturing it talk about manufacturing cost we talk about the merchandiser they talk about the product cost service cost and cost to work on their agenda for the government and non-profit นะครับ the next example นะครับ is gonna be a last example and we are going to do the same thing so you let me know about number 1 2 3 and 4นะครับFlash Logistics นะครับ lead by Mr. Khom San Lee นะครับ that is the first unicorn in Thailand นะครับ they provide transportation of your package they provide transportation of your parcel นะครับ they begin their price around 19 บาทนะครับ very competitive price you can send any parcel in Bangkok within 1 or 2 days and that is like a cost leadership company soMy question is that Flash Logistics rely on number 1, 2, 3, or 4ครับ they provide transportation service นะครับ Flash Logistics ครับ you see very nice oh very nice ครับ I love your answer นะ I love your answer so much นะครับAnyway, if we meet in class, it's gonna be much more fun, นะครับ But anyway, นะครับ Thank you for your participation, นะครับ So, when you look at the Flash Logistics, they don't have any concern on the production. So, all of the costs that they need to control is about the service cost, นะครับ the fleet management.The branch management, นะครับ the pickup point for the customers and how they manage their motorbike and to go around the country. So they are all about the service. You see, so the nature of the cost is totally different from the bread manufacturer. Okay, นะครับ So from now on, I believe that you have a clear understanding. Manufacturing, merchandise.Service firm and government and non-profit okay นะครับ basically government and non-profit นะครับ they get budget or they get money from the government they get money from the people who donate the money for the foundation so นะครับ they just operate their operation to achieve the goal of their organization okay นะครับ so the answer for the flash logistics is service firmนะครับ so the deep understanding of the nature of the business will help you to classify the cost which we are going to discuss later on okay นะครับ Thank you so much นะครับ name Benz Oil Opal Boom กบ Yumi นะครับ Om นะครับ BA นะครับ Nice Foley TT and Dylan นะครับอ่ะโอเคนะครับ very nice I'm very happy to meet you today นะครับ this morning especially this morning นะครับ So let's have a short break นะครับ after that we can continue the remaining chapter นะครับ and then we can begin with the second chapter นะครับ Okay everyone welcome back to our class นะครับ I hope that you have a great break so far นะครับ andAs we discussed, นะครับ we meet around 10:20, นะครับ since the beginning of this chapter, we discussed about the concept, นะครับ why we need to understand about the cost, นะครับ I hope that right now, นะครับ it gain more understanding about the importance of the cost management to your business, นะครับ whether you, as I told you, whether you are going to work in the professional firm or,You are going to move on with your own business. You are going to move on with your family business. Of course, it's one of the primary concern for organization. If you can manage cost well, you understand about the trend of the cost. You understand about what happened to the company. Some of the company, some of my friends, they manage the company and they told me, Vasu, I have a very good sales, but We report a huge loss. นะครับ what happened? So I help them to see นะครับ what is the portion of the cost, what is the portion of the related cost, and how they can implement they can make it better. นะครับ so นะครับ from now on นะครับ let's continue with the following topic นะครับ cost is much more important in the modern economic era นะครับ becauseThere are a lot of the trend like this. นะครับ We are going to discuss about this in brief. นะครับ I hope that you see these are some modern trend. นะครับ That shape the business now today. นะครับ The first one is the shift to a global business environment. นะครับ You can see now the important word here is the economic interdependency. นะครับ In economic interdependency means thatEvery country around the world, they cannot stay alone. นะครับ You can see that Apple นะครับ is the US company, but all of their phone นะครับ produced in another country. You see, so each country they need to rely on each another country. นะครับ And then some of the country they try to be the they try to come up with some economic nationalism. นะครับWhat does this mean? For example, our country first, you see, so we shift up the tariff or the import tax for the other's country product, for example. So there are always a huge competition around the country in this world. The second one is related to us very well. It's called lean manufacturing. You try to reduce the inventory, you try to reduceAnd to arrive at the just-in-time production, นะครับ I remember, นะครับ one of the good example is the Toyota manufacturing, นะครับ the part, นะครับ or the module arrive at the same period when they are interested to produce the car, นะครับ So they don't have a huge warehouse, they don't have a huge inventory, นะครับ So that is what we call lean manufacturing นะครับ in term of the lean manufacturing นะครับ it help company to better manage their cost นะครับ imagine นะ imagine you are going to operate the milk tea shop but if you spare like 100 kilo นะครับ of the milk powder every day you see it is a huge นะครับ inventory นะครับ so the concept of the lean manufacturing is that the raw material arrive almost the same time as when you want to produce it นะครับ but in term of the service นะครับ you need to have enough raw material นะครับ to sell for your customers นะครับ importance of the information technology นะครับ so later on you can see that right now นะครับ we have severaltechnology and several system that help นะครับ the business for example enterprise resource management นะครับ enterprise resource planning for all ERP นะครับ I work on some project with the with the company they try to come up with the ERP system so in the past what did they do they just record in term of the Excel you seeSo it is very difficult to see the information real time. It is very difficult to classify the cost in terms of the category. And moreover, it is very difficult to make a decision. Okay, to have real time. So there are a lot of the opportunity come up with the information technology and system. The business shift to focus on the customers นะครับ in the past if you know นะครับ in the past especially in Thailand basically we produce a product and we sell to the market นะครับ that is what we call the push strategy นะ the push strategy you push the product to the market you want to produce this you sell to the market you try to do the marketing but later on ครับ we focus on the need of the customers and we try to tailor made the productthat fit well with the customer นะครับ so each customers they have expect a different functionality นะครับ easy example is your laptop นะครับ at my laptop that I see you right now this is 15.6 inches I love the big screen you see however some customers they prefer small screen some prefer some customers they prefer the light laptopHowever, some of you might love gaming laptop. You see, 16 inches of the screen are very heavy. You see, so it's the customers they have a variety of the needs that also affect the business. Shift to the customer-based measure. In the past, we just measure the financial performance, but in the modern way, we also think about some customers' perspective. Finally.They are the external factor consideration นะครับ later on if you study strategy ครับ we call page tail analysis นะครับ page tail analysis นะครับ P stand for politics economic social technology environment and legal นะครับ these are the external factor that affect your business okay so for example ครับ if you operate your businessin the central of Bangkok and then if the government announced the lockdown policy you see so it affect your business you see so that is part of the political and social factor นะครับ so นะครับ even you focus on marketing นะครับ management organization or every aspect of organizationSo there is a shift between prior environment to the contemporary environment. Now, the word contemporary is mean modern. For example, in the past, ครับ, you produce a product and that is quite a long product life cycle. I believe that when I was a young boy, when we go to the shopping mall, they always this model of the refrigerator.นะครับ they sell for a years นะครับ but then later on you can see right now even the electric appliance in your home they come and go very fast นะครับ so we call shorter product life cycle so this is for the past this is for the past and this is for the modern situation everything move faster นะครับ you can see that right now for example the telephonenะครับ they come up with the new module นะครับ almost every year นะครับ so the product life cycle is shorter นะครับ so they have a concern on the cost and every aspect of the organization okay นะครับ so when we look at the cost management there are several stages in term of the development everyoneIn the first chapter, there will be a concept, and then later on, once you understand about this concept, later on from the second chapter onward, we are going to discuss into more detail about the concept of the course and we are going to do some calculation together. Okay, now just the first chapter that there are a lot of some broad overview concept. So each of the company, they have a different focus on the cost management. Some of the company, they use cost to predict the future. Some of the company, they just use cost to understand the performance. Some of the company, they are not focused on the cost. Some of the company. Okay, so here is the development from state 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, now state 1 might be a small company. They just put in the transaction for the report system. Oh, today we sell a bread. Okay, 100 bread. Okay, and this is my cost. Just put on the basic transaction. They didn't predict the future and they didn't analyze the variance. Okay, for example, this pack of the bread, the standard cost should be 10 baht. But today we produce it 11 baht. So there are variance. Where is the variance come from? No, they just report the normal reporting. That is the first step. But it is better than having nothing. Okay, so in the first step is the very early development on the cost management of the company. They just focus on the basic transaction report system. You operate the bus. How much the ticket, how many tickets you sell today? 180 ticket. One ticket is 10 baht, so the revenue is 1,800, for example. And we also go to the gas station, 800. We pay for the worker, 300, you see? So that is the basic transaction report. Since the company is growing up, there are a lot of external investors. There are a lot of external parties that they would like to request you for the financial report. So later on, we shall have a look on those examples. So in the second step, as the company grow larger and larger, they need to report some performance to the external people, and then they need a reliable report. So they move on to record more information. They have more classification of the course. They have more systematic. However, they are also based on the reporting system. They didn't use for the decision making. Okay. After that, the companies think that, oh, these are important information and we need to track the key performance. So they track some key information. For example, oh, we know that we operate the bus company. So the gas is very fluctuate in terms of the price. So we need to track the gas price and how we consume that each car, you see. Finally, this is a strategically relevant. It means that the cost information is very important, and then they integrate the cost information to their decision making plan for the future. Plan the number for the future. So there are the development in terms of the state of the cost management together with the company. So as the company grow up, so they have more complexity of the cost management. And then sometime we might discuss about some example of the Microsoft Dynamics. I put some keyword for you. I also work with some company to deliver some kind of this system. Microsoft Dynamics. Microsoft Dynamics is the enterprise resource planning software. With this software, they help you to record all the transaction. They help you to record the cost, and they provide some function for you to analyze it now and also plan for the future. So this is a strategic focus. You think about your mom and pop shop around your home. They just record in their book, you see. Oh, they sell 30 baht, 40 baht. They just record it. You see, that is the basic transaction. They didn't mean anything to the strategic or relevant in the future. So, as the company grow up, you require more and more complexity in terms of the management of the information. You think about 7-Eleven. They sell millions of transactions every day. You see, there are a lot of information. There are a lot of the costs that they need to manage. So, but I didn't say that all of us, we need to arrive at the fourth step. It depends on your situation. But at least your business bring the cost management somehow. Don't worry about this chapter. I would like to provide you a brief concept. And then before the end of the chapter, maybe we discuss about some case study before we finish off. So, what we talk here in this subject, it is the role of the management accountant. So it means that we use accounting information to support management decision. It is also related to the cost management to come up with some performance, to come up with some insight. Good name, our CEO. Last month, we report a very good profit because once we analyze the cost, we see that the gas price is dropped significantly. And also we have some benefit from this. So that's why our income statement come in a very good shape. However, the next month, we believe that there gonna be some change in terms of the cost component. They're going into concern of some of the things. So we may not have a good performance like from the previous month, you see. So what I told you here is that you understand why you have a very good result. You plan for the future, you see. That is the goal of the management accountant. Management accountant in Thai, we call Banchi Phua Kan Bori Han. So it means account to support management. It measure the performance and then they provide some essential information for you to achieve the competitive advantage. Competitive advantage, in Thai, we call ความได้เปรียบในการแข่งขัน. Any business, you need to find out this thing. For example, maybe Thai, for example, he's very good in terms of the calculation. So once he come to the calculation subject, he have a good, he has competitive advantage, you see. Something that you do better than others. For example, Opal, he is very good in terms of the explanation. So when he come to some explanation task, he can do it very well, better than others. So that is what we call competitive advantage. These are the important keywords that we are going to discuss later on. Every company, they need to achieve competitive advantage somehow. This is the keyword that we are going to discuss before we finish off the first chapter. You can see that in the first chapter, we bridge them topic by topic. Finally, in this chapter, I would like to discuss with you about the competitive strategy. Michael E. Porter is the professor in business. He said that every company, if you would like to achieve the great result according to your vision, you need to have a clear competitive strategy, how you are going to compete. I would like you all to think about Thai Airways and AirAsia. You see, they have a different strategy. AirAsia, what is their slogan? Everyone can fly. They focus on the cost leadership. You see, they try to control the cost. They try to manage the cost, and then they can sell the ticket at a very reasonable price. You fly to Chiang Mai, 1,200. You see. But on the opposite way, if you fly with Bangkok Airways, if you fly with Thai Airways, they provide you a very good service, very nice food. You can also load your luggage with them, you see, and then they give you 21 kilograms, for example. But with AirAsia, they're concerned on cost. If you want to load your luggage, you need to add the money, you see. So this company, they have different strategy. Can I help? Any one of you here, maybe some of you, you love coffee. Now, if you drink coffee, now in the coffee is rent from 15 baht. Now, and then if you drink it in a very luxury hotel, maybe per one cup is 500, you see. So in terms of the cost leadership, they might use the normal coffee bean, they might use instant coffee, and then they just put sugar and milk. But when you drink the premium coffee like this, they have some story. You drink at the hotel, this coffee bean come from the rural area of the Africa, and then they have a very good story, and then they use a premium milk from New Zealand to come up with at the right temperature, and you can sip it with a very happy manner. You see, that is the differentiation. So in terms of the etiquette, they have cost leadership, they have differentiation. In terms of the coffee, they have cost leadership and they have differentiation. Okay, so what are the definition of those keywords? From now on, not just these four types of the business. I would like you to see in terms of the manufacturer, they also have cost leadership, they also have differentiation. Okay. Every girl here, when you look at your bag, some of the bag, for example, 200 baht, they focus on the cost leadership. Now, some of the luxury or premium bag, they know that the customer, they have a high purchasing power. So they are the differentiation strategy. They might sell at 100,000. That is expensive. Now, what I would like to say is that, we cannot say which one is good, which one is bad. It depends on your preference. Okay, now I respect everyone. Now, but for me, now I use this. I use this bag. Now, this backpack. Now, just 1,000. I use it many years. So it depends on your preference. We cannot say cost leadership is better than differentiation. We cannot say that differentiation is better than cost leadership. It relies on your strategy, how you are going to win in this business. Okay, now let's move on. So the first one is the cost leadership. The goal is that you are going to outperform competitor by producing at lowest cost, you see? So if we are looking at this normal drinking water, 14 baht, you see? If you go to the 7-Eleven, if you go to the refrigerator, you can see that, oh, 1.5 liter, there are plenty of the brand, you see? So they compete on the cost. The one who can arrive at the lower cost, they have competitive advantage, you see. We cannot say they are going to win or not, but they have competitive advantage. In Thai, we call ความได้เปรียบในการแข่งขัน. Okay? Oh, you come to the calculation subject, you love calculation, you have competitive advantage. Competitive advantage, you see? Highlight 4-star here, competitive advantage. The second strategy we call differentiation. You try to create value for the customer. Oh, everyone, this is a very luxury bag. We have history more than 150 years. We born in France, and then this is the leathers of the premium selected cow that we select from Italy, and then this is the most innovative and new product that gonna fit with you. You see, that is the creating value. ครับ the customer is willing to pay more and more you see you think about some product that you like you see for example ครับ this morning before I come to meet you I went for a jogging in around my home you think about the shoe you can buy 500 baht that is also a running shoe you can buy 1000 2000 3000 4000 5000You see, so some of the running shoe they focus on the cost leadership. Some of the running shoe they focus on the differentiation. You see, so with the differentiation, the customer is willing to pay more because those value. For example, ครับ the latest running shoe that I bought, นะครับ for my New Year present.It has the chip for the GPS and some Bluetooth, and it can connect to my mobile phone. You see, so when I run, I have some information. You see, so that is the differentiation strategies. When you look at the normal running shoe, maybe 400 or 500. You see, it is also a running shoe, but the customers they didn't want those information, so they just.Perform their characteristic. You see, we cannot say which one is better, which one is good. No, it depend on the preference of the customers. Okay, nah. So from now on, I would like to make you clear about these two keywords. Going out, have a look at any product. It must be one among this. Cost leadership or differentiation. So there are some mistakes in the business. We are going to provide the best service to you. We are going to provide the premium service to you at lowest cost. That is impossible. I'm going to charge you 1,000 fly from Bangkok to Chiang Mai. You can load 20 kilogram of the luggage, we give you a very premium food and full service along the flight. Later on, that company will not survive, you see. We call stuck in the middle. So in that sense, it means that if some product, the customer, they are looking for the cost leadership, you have to provide the cost leadership. If the customers is looking for the differentiation,You must provide differentiation product. Okay, now it depends on the preference of the customer. We cannot say which one is good, which one is bad. Okay, now from now on, I hope that you have a clear understanding on this. Cost leadership, in Thai is mean แข่งขันทางด้านต้นทุนนะครับAnd in terms of the differentiation in Thai, we call สร้างความแตกต่าง Okay, นะครับ So, นะครับ As I let you know, if you love to drink coffee, นะครับ15 baht, you can drink coffee, and it range until 500, you see? We cannot say, this one is better, or this one is better. It depends on that customer's need. นะครับ So, we know that 15 baht, นะครับSo profit per one cup is lower, so they try to sell as much as they can. However, cup in terms of the 500 baht, the profit margin is better. Maybe they can sell, sell to some niche market. Okay, so here is some several characteristic and several aspect in terms of the cost leadership. Cost leadership focus on the broad market.Differentiation focus on the niche market นะครับ focus section or niche นะครับ some section that require this characteristic นะครับ lowest cost unique product okay, นะครับ for example normal drink or mineral drink from France for example you see if you wish to go to buy some water นะครับ small bottle 7 baht some of the differentiation 42 baht you see they are very premium นะครับ low price, premium price with innovative feature, for example. So there are totally differences. I would like to metaphor you like this. Cost leadership, differentiation. And in the middle, we call stuck in the middle. We are going to provide the best product to you at the lowest cost. It is impossible. Okay. I hope you have a clear understanding on this. Another example, before we finish off this topic, you may know about the Japanese car. You see, for example, Japanese car, you see, 500,000, you see, cost leadership. A very premium European car, 5 million, you see. Differentiation. We cannot say which one is good or which one is bad. They also a huge target customer of this, and there are also huge target customer on this. It depend on the need of the customers and your strategy. Finally, we may discuss this thing a little bit, and then I believe that we have a very clear understanding on the first chapter. To arrive at the good decision making, you need information. Whether we use the normal gasoline or we move to the electrical vehicle, you see. So first of all, before we arrive at the good decision, you need to understand about the issue surrounding issues. Is there any issue surrounding? Is there any trend from the government? Is there any incentive for the government? I know one company, they said if they move to the electric vehicle, they will get some support from the government. So that will be another pro if they choose that thing. So after that, you identify the alternative action. Is there how many alternatives you have? We discuss about this thing in brief, and then later on, we have a final chapter. We are going to discuss about how we use accounting information to make a decision. You obtain information, you analyze it, you choose the alternative, and then you move on with the implementation. It is like what we are going to eat this evening. That is the same thing. What we are going to eat this evening. You have a look on the promotion. This promotion is very attractive. But we also prefer Japanese restaurant, but they didn't provide promotion. So you develop alternative, you see? You have alternative A, B, C. After that, you analyze it, and then you choose, and then you go for the dinner, you see? So actually, these are the steps that we make a decision. But we may not realize that we follow this decision making process. I and my family, what shall we have this weekend? We see some several promotion. This is good compared to this. We love this buffet. So, what shall we go? We analyze on the several alternative and we choose the best one. So this is how we use the information and make a decision. That is all about the first chapter. That is all about the first chapter. So before we finish off the first chapter, before we finish off the first chapter, I would like to recap you once again here. The first concept that we talk is the cost management information. It consists of finance and non-financial information. Finance is mean number. Non-financial information is mean explanation, mean some story, some explanation behind that. And then we talk about the three core functions of the company. Operation, marketing, and finance. And our cost management is part of the controller. The controller is accounting and the treasurer is the finance. After that, we talk about the four management function นะครับ strategic management, planning and decision making นะครับ operational control, preparation of the financial statement. We discuss about the different type of the organization นะครับ namely manufacturer นะครับ merchandising นะครับ service firm and government. Each of them they have a different in terms of the nature of the cost นะครับWe need to understand about the nature of the business first. After that, we identify the strategy that they apply. Okay? Here is important. Once you know that we are manufacturer, so which strategy we use? Cost leadership or differentiation? Okay, นะครับ So these are the first chapter นะครับ first chapter that we need to understand together นะครับโอเคนะครับ